हेलो एवरीवन, गुड शेपर्ड्स हाई स्कूल बेलापुर वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर ऑनलाइन लर्निंग सेशन स्टैंडर्ड 6 सब्जेक्ट जनरल साइंस यूनिट 1 लेसन नंबर 2 द लिविंग वर्ल्ड। कैन यू रिकॉल लिस्ट द थिंग्स seen in the pictures, say whether they are living thing and non-living things. See, dear children, they have shown you a small picture here. Okay, house, non-living thing, trees, living things, chicken, hen, living things, puppy, living thing, boy, living thing, kite, non-living thing. So you know living thing and non-living thing, you all must have learned from second and first standard. Okay, there are many kinds of plants and animals around us. They show some similarities and some differences. Yet, with the help of certain features, we can tell that they are all living things. These features are not seen in non-living things. Such features are said to be the characteristics of living things. Let us study these characteristics. Characteristics of living things, let me tell you all. First is growth. Second, respiration. Third, excretion. Fourth, reproduction. Fifth, responsiveness to stimuli. Sixth, movement. Seventh, definite lifespan. And eighth, cellular structure. These are the characteristics of living things. If you want to find if this is a living thing or non-living thing, if these all features are there, then only it is a living thing, otherwise it is non-living thing. What differences do we see between the young ones and the adults in the picture? See, my dear children, from left, small puppy, small boy, a girl, correct? A small plant there. Yes, now slowly after some years they have grown up. Now small puppy has become small dog, boy has grown tall, girl also has grown tall. That small plant sapling they have grown, they have planted, that is also becomes big, little bit bigger. Then again after some years dog, the boy became man, adult, like girl also became woman. See the tree, but hen is not there, they ate, their lifespan is not so much. Then after some years they become old, the man become old man, that women become old lady, tree becomes such a big, but dog is not there because they are having their definite lifespan. See now, my dear children, a baby grows up to become an adult person, woman or man. During the period of its growth, the baby gains in height, weight and strength. In the same manner, all animals grow into adults in a certain period. Generally, humans require 18 to 21 years for this growth. Find out how long it takes for the young ones of hens, cows and dogs to grow into adults. Now see, they have potted a plant here, sapling in a pot. They have left side this pot, they have tied a thread, stretched thread. Now after some days, as the plant grows, the thread becomes loose, means in plants also there is a growth. Got it, children? Same way, though all living things grow, animals grow only for a certain period, but plants on the other hand grows on as long as they live. The growth of living things occurs from within the body, which means that growth occurs in all parts of the body. See, growth in banyan and coconut trees. They grow till they live. As long as they grow, means they live after they cut it or then they die. Otherwise, they grow and grow and grow. But human being have a limited period. Yeah. Food is necessary for growth. Yes. Plants make their own food in sunlight. Plants produce food from water, nutrients in the soil, and carbon dioxide present in the air. This process takes place in the leaves of plants. Leaves are the kitchen of a plant. It is brought about in the presence of sunlight with the help of the chlorophyll in the leaves. This process of food production is called photosynthesis. During this process, plants give out oxygen. Plants appear mainly green in color due to the chlorophyll in them. Intake of food by animals. See the picture, how they are eating. Animals, however, do not have chlorophyll. They do not produce their own food. They search for food. Animals such as goats, sheep, horse eat grass, while wild animals such as tigers and lions meet their need for food by hunting other animals which live on plants. The intake of food and the resultant growth is an important characteristics of living thing. As you eat, you will become strong and your body, the whole body will grow. Okay, dear children. So this is the food is necessary for the growth. They have shown here the growth it is. So let me repeat. The first characteristic was growth. All living things grow into adults in certain fixed period. Okay, we human beings, 18 to 21 is the last growth. During this period, they gain height, weight and strength. Okay, children. And growth of plants. When plants grow, there is increase in the width and the height of the stem. Some plants develop branches while others lack this. Plants keep on growing till they are alive. Okay. The growth of all living things is from within the body and in all parts of the body. So, food is necessary. Now here, use your brain power, they have asked. What differences do you see in the growth of trees like the mango, banyan and peepal and that of the bamboo, coconut and toddy plants? Yes, dear children. What difference do you see in the growth of trees? Like mango, banyan, they grow big width-wise and length-wise. But bamboo, straight they grow. Coconut also. Toddy palms. But this mango and banyan tree, they spread like breadth-wise they grow big, and bamboo and coconut they straight, they grow only tall. Okay, now food necessary for growth. This autotrophs and heterotrophs, let me explain your children, because all plants are autotrophs, always remember. That is, they prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. And animals are heterotrophs. All animals and few plants take up ready food from the plants. They are called heterotrophs. And in heterotrophs we divided herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. Herbivorous means grass, plants, eaters. Those who eat grass and plants. Carnivorous, those who eat flesh. And omnivorous, those who eat both plants and animals. Like human beings. Okay, now next thing is, next feature characteristics is respiration. Now this activity they are saying, hold your hand in front of your nose or keep your hand on your chest. What do you feel? if you hold your hand in front of your nose, air, you will feel air coming from the nose. And when you keep your hand on your chest, heartbeats you will feel. If we observe a sleeping dog, what movement of its belly do we see? Up and down, like that. Correct, no? Means what? Living things need oxygen in order to live. Inhaling oxygen and exhaling the carbon dioxide formed in the body due to the use of oxygen is called respiration. Let me repeat again. Mark this answer or write it down. Living things need oxygen in order to live. Inhaling oxygen and exhaling the carbon dioxide formed in the body due to the use of oxygen is called respiration. Animals such as fish, snake, mouse, etc. have specific organs for respiration. On the other hand, plants respire by means of microscopic pores on their stems and leaves. See this, ... From there, they respire. So, respiration is a characteristics of living things. Got it, children? Next, can you recall, is all the food we eat used by the body? What you eat, everything is used by body? Answer is, all the food that we eat is not used by the body. Some part which is not essential and some which is not digested is thrown out of the body. What is the unused part of food converted into? The unused food is converted into excreta or feces. Okay, now excretion means waste substances are formed during the many processes that take place in the bodies of animals. These are called excreta, and the process of eliminating them from the body is called excretion. Okay, let me repeat. The waste substances formed during the different processes that take place in the bodies of the animals is called excreta. And excretion means the process of elimination of waste products from the body. Same way, plants too excrete. Plants also do she. For example, some plants shed leaves in a specific season. Waste substances stored in the leaves of plants are shed along with the leaves and they become yellow. See this, a tree shedding leaves means it is doing she. Got it? Now see here. Take a transparent plastic bag, tie it over a leaf of a plant as shown in the picture. Observe it. After 6 to 7 hours, what do you see? You will see droplets of water collect on the inside of the bag. It means that plants excrete water in the form of vapor. So, So, excretion is a characteristics of living things. See, use your brain power. What is a sticky substance seen on the stem of the babul or drumstick trees? This is also a part of a eliminated product. She it is. Okay, waste. Plants ka waste. Got it? So, excretory organs. Specialized organs present in the animals for the excretion are called excretory organs, like anus. Okay? In plants, the waste substances are stored in the leaves and then shed along with leaves or sometimes through the barks of the trees. Plants also secrete excess of water in the form of water vapors. Now, So children, excretion is a characteristics of living things. Now, observe and discuss. Have you experienced this? What happened immediately after the following actions? Light flashed suddenly into your eyes. What do? You close your eyes. Right? Instantly your eyes blink and you close. Suddenly you felt a pinprick. Suppose somebody, your friend, naughty friend, has pierced one small pin or pen. We feel intense pain, thus we instantly withdraw our hand. Right? The leaves of the mimosa plant were touched. If you touch, what it does? The leaves of mimosa plants are folded at once upon touching. Got it? Next. At sunset, lamps on the street or courtyard are lit. And insects gather around the lamps. Why it is so? In villages you must have seen lamps, no? There all insects gather around. If the lamps are switched off, the insects go away. However, if the lamps are switched on, they are attracted towards the light and are seen flocking near the lamp. Means what? Here a new characteristic is responsiveness to stimuli and movement. See, living things act in various ways when responding to a stimulus. If you suddenly enter a cow shed, the cows and buffalo stand up, they get scared, they begin to move. One or two may even start moving. These are all movements. A creeper planted in the courtyard leans towards a support. Creeper, you have seen a money plant like. A potted plant placed in a window grows towards sunlight. You must have observed this also. It means that plants too show movement. Living things move of their own accord. Living things move according to their own wish. But plants and trees, they don't. Sorry, plants are also a living thing only. They move of their own accord, means according to their convenience. The movement or the change taking place in a living thing at such a time is their response to a stimulus. They are responding, like a potted plant moving towards the sun. They are responding. Correct? Means the moment or the change taking place in a living thing at such a time is their response to a stimulus. It's kind of a stimulus been given and you react like that. Same way plants also. An event that occurs in our surroundings is a stimulus. The ability of living things to respond to a stimulus is called their responsiveness to stimuli. Like suppose winter, suddenly we start shivering, cold temperature goes down, then we start shivering. Means what? A stimulus is occurring and we are responding. That is called responsiveness to stimuli. So responsiveness to stimuli is a characteristic of living things, children. Okay? Plants also give response. Animals also give response. Okay? Next, use your brain power. In each of the examples given above, what is the stimulus and what is the response? The sudden flash of light, pinprick, touch, and light of the lamp are all stimuli. And the actions taken upon these stimuli are the responses. Got it, children? Next, what is the main difference between the movements of plants and animals? that animals can move here and there, plants also, but animals, like we animals, human being, they can move here and there, but plants can't. Plants on the one place only, but their roots moves here and there, and their stems. These are the differences. Now, next, can you tell what do we learn from these pictures? A bird and its eggs, bryophyllum, a mare and her foal, rose cuttings. What it is? Living things produce other living things like themselves. Some animals give birth to their young ones. Some lay eggs. Their young ones hatch out of the eggs. New plants are produced from the seeds, stems, or leaves of plants. Now see this. Bird is hatching. Bird lay eggs. Now after some days, after hatching eggs, small, what? Small birds will come. Bryophyllum and these rose cuttings, no? You will not find rose ka seed. You have to cut the stem and you have to put it in the soil. A mare and her foal. See, a female horse, female of a horse. See, a young one is there, no? Foal means what they do? They give birth to their young ones, these animals. Birds, they lay eggs, they hatch, and then small chicks comes out. Here, rose cuttings, how? You have to cut the stem and put into the soil. Then automatically, the leaves and rose will come. So the process by which a living thing generates a new living thing like itself is called reproduction or procreation. Obvious, hen will give birth to chicken only. Cow to calf, dog to puppy. Same way, a rose cuttings will give rose only. Got it? So reproduction is a characteristics of living thing. Why have so many types of plants and animals been able to survive on the earth even today? What is the reason? All the types of plants and animals perform process of reproduction continuously. That's why they have been seen, no? If the reproduction characteristics is not there, you will not find any living things or plants and animals here on the earth. Got it? Now next. A definite lifespan. Everyone is having their definite lifespan. See, at a certain stage of life, living things become capable of reproduction. Yes. Later on in life, reproduction stage, their organs become weak, and still later, their life comes to an end. In other words, living things die. The lifespan of different animals and plants are different. For example, the lifespan of dog is about only 12 to 18 years, while the ostrich lives for 50 years. You may have wondered what exactly the living things are, how they came into being, and so on. Children, definite lifespan means every living thing has a fixed lifespan. Life comes to an end with death. When organ becomes weak, like we have old man, we become and we die. Correct, no? Same way, every plant and animals have different lifespan. Okay? Now, see, do you know the lifespan of a giant turtle found on the Galapagos Island in South America is about 170 years. On the other hand, the lifespan of the mayfly ranges from 1 hour to 24 hours. See this small one. Okay. Now, next is, observe a honeycomb and a wall. What are they made of? Wall are made up of bricks and honeycomb with their wax. You may have seen the small compartments of a honeycomb. Yes, these compartments are joined together to form a honeycomb. A wall has a bricks. To construct a wall, we firmly join the bricks together. Yes, same way our body is also having a cells. A cellular structure is also a characteristics of living things. Living things are made of small units called cells. All the actions and the processes in the bodies of living things are brought about with the help of these microscopic cells. See, amoeba, paramecium. Some living things are made of a single cell. These are called unicellular organism. Uni means the one, single. Sorry. On the other hand, the living things that are made of many cells are called multicellular organisms, like cockroach, pigeon, we human being. The amoeba and some other microorganisms are unicellular, while man, cow, mouse, cockroach, elephants, banyan tree, the onion plant, etc. are all multicellular organisms. All the characteristics of living things are seen in every cell of a living thing, whether it is unicellular or multicellular. You will find all the characteristics of living things in this. So, cellular structure is the main characteristics of living things. Even though the number of cells may vary, different cells everyone must be having. See, these various living things, these all living things are made of cells. Okay, children, so let me give you the examples of unicellular organisms. Amoeba, paramecium, bacteria. I will repeat again. Amoeba, paramecium, bacteria. Unicellular, those are having single cell. And multicellular, you know the examples they have given in plenty. Got it? Now, institute at work. The institutes that work for the survey and conservation of the various plants and animals in different parts of India are the Botanical Survey of India, started from 1890, and the Zoological Survey of India, started in 1916, respectively. In case you find an unfamiliar plant or animal in your surrounding, you can communicate with this institute to obtain more information about it. Okay, children. Now, next, in what way are plants and animals useful to us? All knows this answer. In what way are plants and animals useful to us? Correct, no, children? See, useful living things. Plants are used for household as well as industrial purpose. For example, fenugreek, methi, potato, okra, bhindi, apple, banana are used as food, while vasaka, adulsa, hirada, bihada, asparagus are used as medicines. Correct, no? Animals are also useful to us. Dogs, cats, cows, buffaloes are kept for domestic uses. Fish, sheep, fowl are used as food, while animals like horses, oxen, camel prove useful in various occupations. The earthworm is very useful in agriculture. Got it? So all animals, all living things are useful. But children, there are some harmful living things also. Some animals and plants around us are harmful to man. For example, mosquitoes and flies spread diseases. Correct? Cockroaches, mice, rats destroyed our food. Lice, ticks also spread diseases. the bites of some poisonous lizards, spiders, snakes, and scorpions can even cause death. If wild elephants enter human settlements, they cause a lot of destruction also. Some plants too can be harmful. For example, harmful plants, underline this, the dodder, Parathenium, and other weeds. Pods of the nettle, Colocasia leaves, cause itching. Plants like oleander, lanthana have a strong odors, smell. The Datura plant is poisonous. Uncontrolled growth of fungi and algae in water pollutes drinking water and may cause the spread of diseases. See, Colocasia leaves, Datura, these all are harmful living things. Scorpion, mice, spider, lizard. Now, wild animals that hunt other animals for food are called predators. This can come for fill in the blanks. For example, tigers, lion, wolves, leopards. Sometimes due to deforestation, such animals enter human settlements in search of food and may kill domestic animals or people. So these are wild animals. You must be watching, no, National Geographic Channel, Discovery. Collect information about various plants and animals found in our surroundings, and then we will discuss in the class. Children, always remember, many plants and animals in nature satisfy our needs. The use of such plants and animals should be restricted only to our needs. We should not pluck leaves, flowers, and fruit unnecessarily. Animals should not be hunted. They should not be teased just for fun. It is the responsibility and duty of all of us to protect plants and animals. What we have learned? We have learned that growth, respiration, excretion, reproduction, responsiveness to stimuli, movement, a definite lifespan, and a cellular structure are the characteristics of living things. Animals grow for a certain period of their life. Plants, however, grow as long as they live. Animals have specific organs for respiration, while plants respire through microscopic pores on their leaves and stems. The process of eliminating waste products from the body is called excretion. All living things have the ability to reproduce. Hen will give chicken, dog will give puppy, like that. Living things move because of their ability to respond to stimuli. Plants show spontaneous movements, but they cannot leave their place and go elsewhere as animals do. Living things have a definite lifespan, at the end of which they die. Many animals and plants are useful to us in our daily life. Some animals and plants can be harmful to us. The smallest unit of a living thing is the cell. This can come for the fill in the blanks. Children, differences and similarities you have to find out by your own, and you have to write down the answers. Okay, next, how is the plant kingdom useful to us? I will dictate. We use plant materials in most of our daily routine. Plants provide us with food in the form of grains, fruits, vegetables, etc. Some plants like Vasaka, Hirada, Behada, Asparagus are of medicinal importance, which we use as human remedies for minor illness. That's it. How is the animal kingdom useful to us? You You can write this answer. Animals are also useful to us, dogs, cats and all. Buffaloes are kept for domestic use. Fish, sheep, fowl are used as a food, while animals like horse, oxen, camel prove useful in various occupations. The earthworm is very useful in agriculture. What makes living things different from non-living things? In living things, we can see growth, feeding, respiration, excretion, responsiveness to stimuli, movement, and reproduction. Living beings also show death. All such characteristics are not seen in non-living things. This marks the difference between living things and non-living things. What helps them to breathe? Yes, children. A fish, gills. A snake, lungs. A crane, lungs aided with air sacs. An earthworm, skin. Man, lungs, diaphragm helps in breathing. A banyan tree, tiny pores on the leaves. A caterpillar, spiracles. SPIRACLES. Okay, children, now fill in the blanks. The process by which plants make their own food is called photosynthesis. To inhale oxygen and to exhale carbon dioxide is called respiration. The elimination of waste substances from the body is called excretion. The ability to respond to an event is called responsiveness to stimuli. On completing their lifespan, every living thing dies. You can write this answer. Write the uses of these animals and plants by your own. Got it? And what are the peculiarities of the movements of these living things? I'll give you only one example. Rest others, you have to write it down. Peculiarities. Snakes. Snakes do not have legs. They creep on the ground. Okay, like this, you have to write it down. Tortoise have claws on their limbs. They too creep on the ground with a very slow speed. Like this, everyone, you have to write it down at home. Write in detail about how the plants and animals found in your surrounding prove useful or harmful. Okay, so you have to write it down by your own. Which are the useful animals, harmful animals, useful plants, harmful plants, by your own. Here, our lesson gets over. Okay, children? Thank you.